time at the Greenbuilt Expo, we are here with our really good friend, Lira Luis. She's here for the Generation Kingspan event, where she's a judge. So let's welcome Lira.
Hello, and it's always nice to be part of this one of your guests. It's been exciting. We've done a number of videos in which it turned out really quite well, right?
Yes, the response has been unbelievable. Thousands and thousands of people watching our videos.
Yeah, it's I think the record breaker was like approximately like 50,000 views within a week of posting the video. So
yes,
we're quite happy and we're appreciative and very thankful for those who are supporting the videos that we're creating.
Right. Yes, I mean, if you combine all the videos that we have done, it's like people like maybe 100,000 or more.
Right, for the whole year,
for
right?
For the whole year, yes.
So what better way, I guess, to celebrate that the end of the year or the closing of the year than in a big conference about sustainability and green building, which is called Greenbuilt here in San Francisco, right?
Right. So, Lira, I always wonder, and I got some people asking me, Lira, how do you do this? How do you decide to become an architect?
Well, I've always wanted to be an architect, like ever since I was in first grade. To a private Catholic school for girls, and one of the nuns asked me, what did you want to be when you grow up? And I said, an architect. And ever since then, I've always been fascinated by drawing and fascinated by how buildings come together or how they construct buildings. And so eventually, I did end up becoming an architect.
Wow. I always wanted also to become an architect, be a designer, but the thing is that when I took the test in Peru for the national test to become an architect, my scores for architecture were not enough, but for engineering they were like good. I did well in math, so that's why I ended up becoming a civil engineer.
Well, it's important to have mentors, you know, to help you guide in a vision of what you wanted for yourself. And I was lucky enough to have some mentors also back then who supported my drawings, you know, my passion for drawing, and also my math teachers, because architecture, we get like approximately 20 courses of math in the course of an undergrad 5-year architecture education. And so I see that as very important. And now that I'm an architect, I value mentoring also future architects. Like, say, for example, you mentioned the Generation Kingspan architecture competition that culminated here in Greenbuilt, where we judge one of the winners. And it's going on right now at Greenbuilt. There is a social winner through social media posts, and then the judge winner, which is comprised of a panel of architects and other building industry or green building professionals, and I'm one of the architects, so I've been the winner. So in a way, I find online competitions like that is it's changing the course or the idea of mentorship in a way that's going more on a more positive. Well, it's not that it's not positive, but it's enhancing the tool by way of social voting or social media. And the reason I say this is because now when the students who are entering the competition post their work online, architects who have been selected as the judges, or, you know, or people outside their school or outside the realm or the circle of professors that they have, they could actually get crits or feedback on their work, and if, you know, and these are very valuable feedback because they're tapping into the creative approach, or they're tapping into the ideas of working professionals or working architects outside or beyond what they normally would just have in a typical university setting. So in my way of mentoring, is more on that, I would say, a virtual type of mentoring by being a judge in a competition.
combined with social media that we have talked in the past here in the city of San Francisco, so you can look it up on our and mentoring other people, collaboration, helping others, and that's something that I would like to do too. So you'll see Oral Foundation. Just look it up in the description of this video. So wow, so you being a judge and that's incredible. Helping other people to move forward, that's pretty much what we would like to do by doing these videos, helping other people, giving them ideas and helping them to move forward.
Yeah, and also commenting, like participating in the conversations online. Like the last video that I was a guest of that you prepared or you produced, I saw that some people were commenting about the topics that we talked about, like social media and other stuff. And, you know, we want to make sure that the people who are watching the videos are being heard. So I tried to comment, like personally comment, and address those questions that they have, which I think makes them feel, when you're watching us, which makes you feel that you are actually part of my conversation.
So, okay, everybody, friends, let's go for a little break and we'll be right back. Welcome back. It is Enrique and friends. Lira, can you please tell us what is the value of design?
Well, to me, the value of design really centers around the concept that you want to influence, you want to touch the lives of the people who you're designing for, whether it's a residence or a school or a hospital or an office building, that those people, the end users, come back and say, hey, thank you for designing this space for me because our lives have been changed or have never been the same because of the experience we have while being inside the space that we designed for us.
Wow, that's a really concise way to put it. So, all right, everybody, this is Enrique and friends, and again, from the wonderful city of San Francisco at the Greenbuilt Convention. So, tune up for our next following videos. And from the city of San Francisco, thank you Lira for being again with us and to share all your ideas and all your opinions about